Hi, I wanted to build a small dust extractor that was smaller than one of these big dust extractors, but not as powerful or loud as a shop vac. Something where you just need to suck a little bit of dust, not so hard, and you don't want something super loud or consuming as much power as a shop vac does. So I built this thing, my small dust extractor. Now building this thing has been a lot of experimentation, so in this video I'm just going to talk about how I built the blower for this thing. I bought this motor blower unit from a surplus sale a long time ago, and this has only got a 1/3 horsepower motor and it blows almost as hard as a shop vac. So I figured 1/3 horsepower should be enough. But I didn't want to use this unit here because I have no idea where you could get another one of those. So really nobody else could reproduce this. So instead I used a 1/3 horsepower motor that came out of a tile saw that I got out of the garbage. New tile saws can be had for as low as $50, so these motors are not that expensive. So this is running way too slow and drawing way too much current, so that motor is overloaded. So the reason this fan is overloaded is it's drawing too much air and it has to accelerate a lot of air. So if I just block airflow into it, it'll speed up by quite a lot. If I put the fan in a round enclosure, it can spin up much faster. And that's pretty much full speed. So I have a primitive sort of round enclosure with a gap right there and the hole in the middle. So let's test this again. So this is not running full speed. So I'm still overloading that motor. I have to shorten those fan blades a little bit more because it just doesn't have enough power to turn that thing when there's all that airflow in it. For any sort of radial centrifugal type blower, the more air you have flowing in it, the harder it has to work. So let's plug this guy in.
And it's consuming about 360 watts. Let's stop the air. And now we're down to about 185 watts, less than half of what I had before.
The reason the blower needs more power when there's more airflow is whenever new airflow is in here, that has to be accelerated round and round and shot out here. Whereas if I plug it up, the same air can just circulate around and around and around, so there's much less work the blower has to do. In the meantime, I have to shorten these blades a little bit. I kept experimenting with this blower and I kept shortening and shortening the blades because I just didn't have enough power. But then I didn't have enough pressure anymore, so with a sufficiently round enclosure and restricting the airflow, I could make the blades a little bit longer again, so I had to glue some pieces of wood on there. I've been having a lot of difficulty because my motor is just not powerful, and I'm thinking this impeller may not be the most efficient. For most fans of this type, you have an impeller of a bunch of curved blades that is sandwiched between two smooth discs. So I've made this new impeller, which fits into here like so, and the blades curve away from the direction of rotation, which is how they always go for greater efficiency. So that way, as the air moves out, some of the Coriolis forces actually cause it to be pushed out further, and we put a little bit less torque on the motor, so hopefully that will work. Now I've tried this out before, but just a centrifugal force caused it to warp a little bit and rub against the sides here. So next I need to glue this disc on here, and hopefully that will prevent warpage, but then you can't see the blades anymore. So I've been getting some vibrations from this impeller, so I know it's not perfectly balanced. And I figure the best way to balance this impeller is I've got a marble that just barely doesn't fit through the hole in here. And then to try to put this whole thing down on a block of wood. And I can see that it tilts this way. This side's always lower. So I'm going to cut away a bit of wood from here to try to bring it so it sits level. Well, I think that's as balanced as I'm going to get it. So with the new impeller and the blower worked well enough, and then I focused on building the rest of the dust extractor. The blower on its own blows quite hard, hard enough to suspend one of these marbles above the outlet. I used a pitot tube to measure the airspeed. I got 132 millimeters head of water, which works out to about 46 meters per second on the outlet, or about 167 kilometers per hour. That works out to about 55 liters per second or 120 CFM of air. If I completely block the intake, static suction is about 230 millimeters of water, and power consumption drops by about half. The other main component of this dust extractor is the centrifugal separator, which is sort of a cross between a theme baffle and a cyclone separator. And that thing is interesting enough that I'll make another video just about that.